3D printers have a problem, and this could be a solution. On the horizontal, plastic is melted continuously, and it's almost as strong as injection molded parts. But on the vertical, it is much weaker. The problem is that between layers, filament lines don't fuse so well, and tiny gaps are aligned, making them even weaker. We can use more plastic. But some people suggested this, and Stefan from CNC Kitchen made an excellent video testing brick layers. So instead of printing like this, we would have this. And it got stronger. I said, this is genius! And I was sure that maybe in a month or two, we would have a brick layers option in every slicer. 7 months later, and nothing. Why not? Yeah, I am not a lawyer. Anyway, why don't we have brick layers yet? It seems that between us and happiness, there is a patent. Not a troll, because they seem to be an actual 3D printing company offering this technique as a service with their own slicer, and that's fine. But should the patent be valid? First, I have a mind-bending question for you. Look at the gaps. Are the gaps good or bad? You probably said, gaps are bad. They make the parts weaker. We should have no gaps at all. If we increase the flow, we might eliminate the gaps, right? Now, open your Orca slicer, go to calibration, flow rate, and each of these will have a little bit more or less flow. Then you print them. You compare side by side, pick the one that feels smoother, and if you look close enough, you will see gaps. And over-extruding gets terrible. How much porosity is the sweet spot? Let's get back to a time when most of us didn't know about 3D printing. In 1995, Stratasys filed this patent, Method for Controlled Porosity Three-Dimensional Modeling. This patent had only 3 drawings and 16 protections. These are the drawings. Anyone saying that it was about infill didn't read the patent. It was about how the beads were fed side by side on the solid areas. This is brilliant, actually, but as a patent, very broad and restrictive, because in practice, it was, and it still is, almost impossible to print well without allowing some porosity, without any gaps. And any porosity between 1 and 21% was protected. So, legally, because of claim 12, only Stratasys could extrude like this. And because of claim 13, only Stratasys could extrude like this. So, answering Stefan's question.
I did a bit of research, yet couldn't find any patents on this method. Yet, if there are any, please let me know.
Yeah, there was a patent. This, from 1995. 20 years later, the patent expired in the US and later in Europe. Everything described here is now public domain. Since 2016, anyone can extrude beads this way, and also this way. We can choose. And finally, in 2019, someone opened an issue on Prusa Slicer's GitHub, requesting hexagonal walls, saying, this will provide higher strength. And the image also showed how the first layer should be and how to finish. That's what Stefan tested. It used a technique that is under public domain. This shouldn't exist in our lives. This new patent from 2020 says they are improving strength between layers. How are they improving it? by printing the same hexagonal pattern. They describe using this valley configuration reduces the porosity of the finished part. Well, that was already claimed in 1995 by Stratasys. Where is the new invention? You just need to put them side by side. Didn't the examiners compare them? Because this new patent even mentioned a Stratasys patent. Look, you just need to type the number. What's this? This is not about 3D printing at all. The number is wrong. This is the right number of Stratasys' expired patent. Did the examiners ever study the prior art? This one is also wrong. The right number is 2018. And this is about inkjet 3D printing, not FDM. And this one I could never find. In the European application, the number is shorter. And I'm still trying to find it. This patent doesn't show a new invention. It contains wrong references to prior art. Maybe it confused the examiners. The only thing that this patent does is to acknowledge that this is stronger than this. But then, in 2019, this guy already said that publicly. Why should we wait until 2040? The whole world can 3D print hexagonal layers today. So, this is me, months ago, inspired by Stefan's video. 56. I made my first Arduino load cell measuring tool. The test itself was kind of dangerous and scary. I really need to make a proper machine. Then I found out about the 2020 patent, which was frustrating for many people. The errors in referencing prior art should be taken very seriously. And it took me many weeks before I stumbled on what the Porosity patent really was. I need your help to share this video with anyone involved in open source slicers. The lesson I learned is that old patents are treasures. We should know them, study them. If we don't, we risk having old inventions repatented right under our noses. As you can imagine, I couldn't find a sponsor to support this video. So if you can pause it now and buy me a thanks, it would really help my work. In the description, you'll find a link to an open Patreon post with all the details about these patents. Oh, and if you didn't watch the original Bricklayers video from CNC Kitchen, you should. The link is in the description as well. Don't forget to like this video, share it, and subscribe. Thanks for watching to the end.